Welcome to Everything and Anything, the channel that helps you with everything and
today,
anything.
Today, we're going to learn how to count and do a sum with different conditions. So we're looking at this data table. This data table, you can find it in the description. You will have the link to the online platform where I found it. It is for free, so you can download it before starting with this exercise. In this table, we do see that there is employee ID, full name, job title, department, and other column with the headers. We do see that there are several repeating data. So as you can see here, we do have sales, IT, finance repeating several times. We do also see different countries, as well as a gender. So let's imagine, we want to count the number of people that are male, and we want to count the number of people which are female. Let me make this tab a little bit bigger so we can all see what we're looking into. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to count the number of people that are male. So we're going to do a count if. So we're going to write equal count. You can do a count where you count the number of rows, but as we want to know only the rows which are male, we're going to use count if. So let's double click on this. We're then going to go and select the range that we want to learn about. So here I can click on data. And I'm going to select the column which is showing those data. So here, because I want to know how many rows are showing male, I'm going to select the column gender. I'm then going to put a comma, and then I'm going to write the criteria. Depending on the version of Excel that you have, the criteria might change. Here, as you can see, we have the comma, so I'm just going to go and write equal, and then select male. Because of the version that I have of Excel, it's not going to allow me. It's going to tell me that there is a problem. As you can see here, the equal, it's telling you that there is a character which is not working. What is happening is here, as you can see, the equal is not really considered as equal. What I mean by that is you're going to need to add a few things to make it understand that it's a calculation. We want it to be exactly the same as. So what we're going to do, we're going to add here, just this, as well as end, this symbol here. As you can see, at the moment we added that, this part of the equation just updated as a color. And that tells us that it's actually taking it into account. So let's type equal here. We're going to do exactly the same for females. So just to do, we can just go lower here. So we want to know the amount of salary. So we're going to do a sum if. So I'm going to do equal, sum, and then we're going to add the if, as you can see here. And then we're going to select the range that we want to compare it to. As you can see here, we have a first range with the criteria attached to it, and then the sum range. So first we want to compare the criteria. Criteria here is male. So we go back to data. We select gender again. We do put a comma. We put the equal with the symbol that we looked at before. And then we're gonna go back to our document, and then we're gonna get add male. Just did a small typo here, so let me just change this. And then we're gonna want to select the range that we want to count. So we want to do a sum of. So we're gonna go back to data, and then we're gonna select all the annual salary. And then we're gonna go back. As you can see here, I have a certain amount. Let me put it in. Accounting in currency. So as you can see here, I just selected this little bill here. What to do if I want it to be female? I'm just going to double click, verify everything, and then I can just go lower. So here you have female. There is more female in this data tab, and then there are also more. The high annual salary is on the sum is bigger. Something interesting is even though it's higher and there is a higher count, the average might be different. So let's do an average quickly. We do equal, and then we're going to count average. We're going to do an average if again. We're going to first select the range, the criteria, and then the average sum, exactly as we have done it for the sum if. So let's go into data. The first range we want to is male because we want to know the amount of people which are male and what is their average salary. We do a comma, again, we do exactly the same as we've done before. So we put the equal with the symbols that we've highlighted earlier. we go back to our second tab, and then we're going to click on mail, and then we can just do a comma again, and then go to data, and then do an average. We can then close the parenthesis and then equal. Let's just drop it down so we can have exactly the same as a female. So to drop down, you just see the square here. So you can just select it and then bring it down. And then we're going to just select those two and then format it as a currency. Let me make it just a bit bigger. And as you can see, the female in general are paid higher. Even though this is interesting, this is taking just one condition. However, let's imagine I want to know male and female, but I also want to know the country they're in. So as you can see here, we have China, United States, and Brazil. So to make sure I have all the country, I'm going to select this. I'm going to do Control C. I'm going to go back to my second tab. I'm going to do a Control V, and then I'm going to go into data, and then I'm going to delete. Here, you can see this little next to text to column, or you will have often duplicated data. So here we're going to have remove duplicates. We select remove duplicates from that column. Okay. And then we can see we only have three duplicated. So that means they only have three main countries. We're going to Control C, and then we're going to paste special. I want it to be pasted as transpose. So what does that mean? It just means that they're going to be, instead of being in a column, they're going to be in a row. And why do we want that? Is because we still want to know the difference between male and female. So let's look at the equation that we had earlier. I'm just going to put a view and I'm going to add the formula bar so you can all see what I'm talking about. Let me delete those here. So we want two conditions. We want to know how many count of people in the United States are males. So we want to count if, but as I said, there are two conditions. So here we're going to use the count ifs. And then we're going to look at criteria range one. So our first range is we want to know who is working in the United States. So I'm going to go into my data. I'm going to select the column of the countries. And then I'm going to put a comma. As you can see here, you still have the explanation of the count ifs and how it works. It is a comma. Some Excel will tell you that it's, it can be something else. It can be a dot. It can be other separation. It depends how your computer is set up. Here we have a comma. So we're just going to put a comma. And as you can see, it's updating here. Then we're going to put the equal as we've looked at before with a different condition. And we're going to go back to our second tab and select what we want. Because I'm going to move this around, I know I don't want this to move, so I'm just going to add the dollar sign right before and after my column and my rows. So we have a first condition. So right now, we're counting all of the people which are working in the United States. However, I want to count now all the people that are male and working in the United States. So we have all of the people working in the United States. I'm just going to put a comma, and then we're going to search our second criteria. In our second criteria, we're going to go into data. We're going to go into selecting the column F. And then we're going to do again the equal as we've looked at previously. And then we can go into our second tab and then we select male. Here, I'm not going to block it, meaning I'm not going to put a dollar sign because I'm going to drop it down for it to be female. And then we can close it. As you can see here, 306. And then if I bring it down, we're going to have 328. I can then, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move it on the side. And then you're going to see it's coming at zero. And I want to highlight why is this doing that. So first, as you can see, this, which is a red, is supposed to be male. The blue, which we blocked because we brought it down to female, should be China. So if, let's imagine, if we just select like this, and then if I put enters, it's still going to be wrong. And this is because when we move, Excel, most of the time, if you don't block any of the column, we'll move them. So here, for example, we are looking at the M column, whereas previously we were looking at the L column. What is the impact? If you look at the M column is actually looking at the cities, so nothing to do with the countries. Even though the cities and countries are linked, The system doesn't know. So what we're going to do is we're going to do something simple. We're just going to literally go back to our cell, copy the full formula within the formula bar, so Control C, then we enter, we go back to the other cell and Control V. We then can just change United States and then bring it to China. And then we can drop it down. Let's do the same. We're just going to Control V, again select, and then we're going to move it to Brazil and then bring it down. So in total here, we can do a quick sum to see if our results are correct, because above we have the total count. We can do a sum. And we can select everything right here. As you can see, 485 and 515 exactly as we have above. So let's do this again, but let's look at the sum. We want to know the sum of salary paid for a male in the United, for males in the United States. So again, as we did for the countif, we're going to do sum and sum ifs for two conditions. We're going to first select the sum range. So I'm going to go back to my data. I want to know the salary. I want the salary to be my sum. And then we're going to put a comma because, again, the formula is telling me to. It might be something else for you, so make sure that you double check what it is. Put a comma. What is our criteria range? So first we want to know what country they're in. So I'm going to add our equal as well as the symbols that we have, the end. I'm going to go back to my tab. I want it to be related to this. And then comma again. And then my second criteria, I just want to know about males. So gender, again, equal, end. And then I go back to my tab and then male. And I enter. I'm just going to drop it. I'm going to select it again. And I'm just going to block, as I've done for the count, I'm going to block with dollar sign the United States, just because I'm going to drop it down to female. And then I'm just going to make it as currency. So I go back to the top and then I'm going to put it as a currency in the formatting. What we're going to do then, again, I'm going to select it all and not move it around because not all of the column have been blocked. And then I'm going to just copy like exactly the same way I did for the count if above. Then I'm going to double click on China and then I'm going to move it around. And then I'm going to double click for the data on Brazil. I'm going to move it to Brazil. As you can see here, I'm then just going to select and drop it down, change it as a currency. What we can do here is we can just change everything as a sum again, just to verify our data. And then change it as currency. Again, as you can see, our data are perfectly right. I hope this helped you. You can now do some counts as well as some sum and average using several conditions. Make sure that you have the right data and make sure that whenever you do an equation, you see and highlight those dollar signs. Some Excel might have dollar signs on the data, on the column that you select. Some might not have. So make sure that whenever you move things around, you verify your data. Hope you enjoyed this video and it helps you. Like, subscribe and comment. Let us know what else you might need help with. We are able to help you with everything and anything.
Indeed, everything and anything.